experiences in front of others, when we do or say something stupid, when we're not accepted for who we are, when we're laughed at for not looking right or dressing right. To be shut out is the worst way to fall flat. At school, we know there are kids who are on the outside looking in, but we don't invite them in. What would our friends think? Jesus fell flat in front of the soldiers, in front of people who had believed in him, in front of his own mother. He was in this situation because he had spoken out and taken risks for others. Look where it got him. What must he have been thinking as he lost control and fell under the cross? Jesus, forgive us for the times we have shut others out and refused to help. Help us to be aware of their needs. Teach us how to follow you. The fourth station, Jesus meets his mother. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you. Parents expect so much of us. They want us to succeed. They want to believe that we can get good grades, that everyone will like us, that we will never cheat or lie or steal, that we will always choose what is right. And we want our parents to think the best of us. We don't want them to know about some of the things we do. Mary wanted Jesus to succeed. She wanted people to accept him, to believe him, to love him. But here she meets him, and he is carrying a criminal's cross. Did she think that he was guilty, that he was a failure, or did she love and support him? Jesus, forgive us for the times we have resented our parents. Help us to be grateful for their love and support. Teach us how to follow you. The fifth station, Simon helps Jesus.
We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you. Sometimes a teacher makes us sit next to an outsider, or makes us help someone we want to be caught dead with. We don't stop to think about the other person's feelings. We only care about how we feel. How does this look to our friends? What if they think we chose the situation? Poor Simon. Why was he, a foreigner, chosen to help this criminal carry his cross? Would people think he was a criminal too? He was probably embarrassed and humiliated to be forced into the situation. Was there even a moment when he forgot his own discomfort and looked with compassion at Jesus? Jesus, forgive us for the times we have hurt others by not caring how they feel. Show us how to act with love and compassion. Teach us how to follow you. The sixth station, Veronica wipes Jesus' face.
Keep me at
We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you. There are people who sometimes actually buck the crowd. When everyone else is drinking, or doing drugs, or telling crude jokes, or tearing someone down, this person speaks up. Hey, this isn't right. This isn't good. I refuse to go along. And everyone laughs. Veronica bucked the crowd. Her sympathy overcame her fear, and she came forward to wipe the blood and sweat from Jesus' face. She didn't stop to think about the consequences or to measure her own needs. At that moment, she only thought about the needs of Jesus. Jesus, forgive us for the times we have laughed at people who buck the crowd. Help us learn to accept the truth about ourselves and the things we do. Teach us how to follow you. The seventh station, Jesus falls again. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you. Failure is a terrible thing. None of us wants to be a failure, especially in the eyes of our friends. Parents and teachers might think of us as failures, but when friends do, it's too much. All day, we are concerned about what our friends will think. We work hard to look good in their eyes, but sometimes they fail us. They don't stand by us when we need them, in spite of all of our efforts to please them. When Jesus fell again, what were his concerns? Was he worried about how his friends were taking this? And where were his friends? Why didn't even one of them step forward on his behalf? Was he angry or hurt? What was he thinking as he plunged to the ground for the second time? Jesus, forgive us for the times we have failed to be there for our friends when they needed us. Help us to be as caring as you always are for us. Teach us how to follow you. The A station, the women weep for Jesus.
We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you. Sometimes a crowd mentally takes over at school. Things we would never do on our own seem okay when everyone else is doing them. We tend to gang up more on the losers when we're in a crowd. The women in the crowd who wept for Jesus were crying because the situation called for tears. The crowd was stirred up and noisy. Frightening things were going on. The women were too curious to leave, but too afraid to keep quiet. And so they cried. As Jesus passed by, he heard them. He told them to stop the phony crying and to weep instead for the evil being done. He was asking them to follow their own hearts, not the crowd. Jesus, forgive us for the times we have gone along with the crowd without accepting responsibility for what we do. Help us to get in touch with what we really think and feel. Teach us to follow you. The ninth station, Jesus falls for the third time. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you. To be made fun of once is bad enough. To happen again and again is agony. Yet there are people in our school, in our neighborhood, who are made fun of all the time. And we do it to them too. They don't fit in. They don't belong. So it's okay. Everyone does it. Everyone knows how different they are. They fall down in front of us over and over, and we just knock them down again. Jesus fell 3 times with the cross on his shoulders. All these people watching, what were they thinking? He had helped so many of them, but not one of them had the courage to come forward. Were they frightened of the soldiers and the angry crowd? Or was it simply that Jesus was no longer one of them, so they let him fall? Jesus, forgive us for the times we make fun of others. Give us the courage to lift them up when they fall, even if they don't fit in. Teach us how to follow you. The 10th station, Jesus is stripped of his clothing.
Take all my freedom, my liberty, my
adore you, O Christ, and we praise you. Clothes are a big part of our lives. The right clothes cost a lot, sometimes more than we or our parents can afford, but we insist on having them. We want to look right. We have to be dressed like everyone else. There are people we know who don't dress right, and we know what happens to them. Without the right clothes, they're nothing. Jesus was stripped of his clothing in front of a whole crowd of people. He stood there without the comfort and security of his clothes. He was stripped of his dignity like a criminal. Without his clothes, how must he have felt? Jesus, forgive us for the times we have cared more for good clothes than for good people. Help us to never value designer labels more than the needs of others. Teach us how to follow you. The 11th station, Jesus is nailed to the cross.
We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross, you have redeemed the world.
At times we do things that are ugly and wrong. We say hateful things about others. Black people, white people, poor people, Hispanic people, Asian people. We call them names because they're different, and we've decided that we're better. We join others who laugh at them. Deep in our hearts, we know this is wrong, but we go along with it anyway. Jesus was the victim of anger and jealousy. He had stirred up the people. He had said and done different things. He had accepted all people equally as they were. Now he was paying the price. There must have been those in the crowd who knew he was innocent, but they went along with the way things were. They stood by and let Jesus be nailed to the cross. Jesus, forgive us for the times we have nailed others to the cross because they were different. Show us how to love and value people as you did. Teach us how to follow you. The 12th station, Jesus dies on the cross.
Your hands I commend my spirit. You will redeem me, faithful God. neighbors laugh and friends stand tall.
We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you. We all think about dying from time to time. It's a thought that comes to us when things go wrong, when a boyfriend or girlfriend rejects us, or when our grades are slipping, or when we're drinking or smoking too much and can't seem to stop, or when our parents are disappointed in everything we do. We are tempted to believe that death is easier than facing our problems. Is this what Jesus was feeling as he died? Was he hoping to get it over with? Or was he worried about his friends, his mother, his followers? Was he angry at God and at life? What did he mean when he said, "Forgive them, they don't know what they're doing"? Was he really so unselfish that he could pray for those who hurt him? Please kneel. Jesus, forgive us for the times we quit too easily because we're only thinking of ourselves. Share with us the kind of unselfish courage you had. Teach us how to follow you. You may be seated. The 13th station, Jesus is taken down from the cross. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross, you have redeemed the world.
Sometimes we clearly recognize a lost cause, a school team that never wins, a band that can't make good music, a friendship completely broken. We don't want to be part of a lost cause, but we often are. We're on that losing team, or in that band, or part of that broken relationship. What then? Joseph of Arimathea, a secret follower of Jesus who was afraid of the leaders, finally came forward after Jesus had died. He claimed the body of this criminal. What made him do it? Wasn't he still afraid of being identified with a lost cause? No doubt he was ashamed for waiting so long, but at least he did something good and courageous in the end. Jesus, forgive us for the times we walk away from painful situations and from the people in them. Give us the courage to act on our beliefs, no matter how afraid we are. Teach us how to follow you. The 14th station, Jesus is placed in the tomb.
Thank you.
We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross, you have redeemed the world.
When we have worked hard at something, we expect to be rewarded. A good grade, praise from our parents, cheers from the fans. We certainly don't want to be blamed or punished for doing our best. It happens sometimes, though, to people we know, and we walk away from them. We don't want to hang out with losers. Jesus spent his public life preaching, healing, and helping others. He promised good things to those who followed him. But here he was, dead from crucifixion, and apparently good things had not happened to him or to those who believed in him. At this moment of sorrow and failure, his followers had abandoned him, and he was buried in another man's grave. Jesus, forgive us for the times we have measured our success by the applause and praise of others. Help us learn to look beneath the surface of things with the eyes of faith. Teach us how to follow you. Jesus, we know that your story didn't end on Good Friday. Your failure was turned into victory on Easter morning. Jesus is not here, your messenger said. He has been raised from the dead. As your followers, we know that rejection, loss, even death and dying don't necessarily mean failure. With your help, we can move through these experiences toward new life and resurrection. We can be turned around as you were. Give us the courage, please, to accept the reality that life will always have its bright sides and its dark sides, its joys and sorrows. And help us to believe that God has good things in store for us too. Amen. Please leave the church quietly.
I will sing to the Lord for his victory. Horse and chariot cast in the sea. Cast down the horse and chariot in the water.